COMELEC Chief George Garcia determined to clear himself from allegations of receiving bribe money in exchange for picking Miro systems for next year's elections. Sige Party List Representative Rodante Marcoleta recently presented deposit slips from Garcia's alleged accounts in two offshore banks in the Cayman Islands. The poll chief points out the supposed depositor has ties to the country's previous election provider, Smartmatic. The company was banned from bidding for election contracts after being implicated in a corruption probe by the U.S. Garcia also presented email exchanges with the Cayman Island banks, stating he has no accounts with them. Garcia says he is only waiting for the results of the probes of the NBI and Anti-Money Laundering Council so he can file an ethics complaint against Marcoleta.
Pag ginamit po na yung NBI investigation at saka po ng anti-money laundering investigation, mabigat po yun kahit sa korte tayo makarating o kahit sa ano pang body o kapulungan tayo makarating.
Smartmatic calling Garcia's allegations unfair and unjust. Marcoleta, meanwhile, says he is unfazed by a potential ethics complaint.
Kung meron siyang ground na mag-file ng ethics complaint, kung palagay niya tama yung gagawin niya, we are in a democracy, why don't he do it?
Vice President Sara Duterte draws flak for her scathing criticism of the Marcos administration. One of her Senate allies believes the backlash against the vice president is meant to derail her future electoral plans.
Several lawmakers hit back at Vice President Sara Duterte for criticizing the Marcos Jr. administration. In a letter addressed to her Muslim supporters, Duterte slammed the Marcos government for its alleged failure to come up with a comprehensive plan for disaster response. But Manila 3rd District Representative Joel Chua pointed out the vice president was nowhere in sight when the country was ravaged by Typhoon Karina and the southwest monsoon. At the height of the typhoon, the vice president went on a personal trip with her family overseas. The office of the vice president admitted that the timing of the trip was unfortunate, but assured that Duterte has institutionalized their disaster operations center that can function without her. Congressman Chua also hit Duterte's alleged silence on Chinese harassment of Philippine vessels in the West Philippine Sea. Chua said he and his colleagues at the lower chamber would make the vice president account for her huge spending over the last 3 years when the House takes up the OVP budget. The OVP had 702 million pesos in 2022 when Duterte took over from then Vice President Leni Robredo. This jumped more than three times to 2.3 billion in 2023. This year, the office of the vice president is allocated 1.8 billion pesos. Senator J.V. Ejercito, for his part, believes the vice president's criticism of the Marcos administration does not send a very good signal to the international community.
Nagkakaroon ng doubts about our political stability if the top two officials are not united or not don't have a very good working relationship. So it's ako personally, I think it's a sad development, no, na umabot at humantong sa ganito ang relasyon ng ating pangulo at nating pangalawang pangulo. I'm hoping that they would still be able to repair and improve the relationship.
Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel meanwhile said, instead of criticizing the Marcos administration, Duterte should have given her countersona or State of the Nation address. Senator Ronald De La Rosa, an ally of the Dutertes, for his part suspects the ongoing probe on the war on drugs at the House of Representatives is part of efforts to demolish the vice president ahead of the 2028 presidential elections. De La Rosa alleges Speaker Martin Romualdez, Congressman Zaldi Co, and former Senator Antonio Trillanes are plotting against the vice president.
Most likely, because the effort is there, lata naman natin. Sinong speaker of the house? Romualdez. Mm-hmm. Eh, sino yung nandoon na nag-convince, nung-convince sila na mag-testify against Duterte, they will erase their perceived opposition.
Mm-hmm.
So, kuha na sila, sigurado na sila, happy na sila, na sila na tuloy-tuloy. Mm-hmm. Tuloy-tuloy na sila, they'll be, mga continue na sila sa power. Dahil kung idaan sa eleksyon, mukhang mahirapan naman talaga sila kay Vice Mayor, Vice President Inday Sara. Mm-hmm. So, hanap sila ng paraan na ma-eliminate yung opposition.
In a statement, Congressman Ko said he met Police Major General Romeo Karamat a few months ago at the house of Speaker Romualdez. Ko said Karamat was willing to tell everything he knows about the extrajudicial killings in exchange for his appointment as PNP chief. But this was rejected by the speaker. Karamat is the former chief of the Criminal Investigation and Detection Group and is currently the acting area commander of Northern Luzon. The lawmaker asserts he never met with other police officials. ANC tried to get a reaction from Speaker Romualdez and former Senator Trillanes. They have yet to respond.
The Court of Appeals approves the freezing of the assets of fugitive televangelist Apollo Kibuloy and his religious group, Kingdom of Jesus Christ. These include Kibuloy's 10 bank accounts, 7 properties, 5 vehicles, and an aircraft. The religious leader is accused of sexual abuse, human trafficking, and money laundering in the Philippines and in the U.S. Senator Rizzo Ontiveros lauds the court order, saying the fugitive pastor deserves it. She also hopes this freezes Kibuloy's ability to escape. Philippine authorities believe the fugitive televangelist and his co-accused are just hiding inside the compound of the Kingdom of Jesus Christ in Davao City. According to Davao Regional Police Director Brigadier General Nicolas Torre III, there's intense vigilance among KOJC members in the area. He also says Kibuloy remains a flight risk since the compound has a hangar and a private taxiway to Davao International Airport. But he assures the public the PNP's air assets are ready for deployment should they try to escape.
Sa ngayon, we are concentrating on hammering into his head and his lawyer na the only way for this to be resolved peacefully and with justice for all is for him to submit to the jurisdiction of the court, just like what his companions, si Mr. Kibuloy lang ang bukod-tangin na hindi nagpiyansa. So it is already an indication, kahit ano pang sabihin ng kanilang mga abogado, na talagang valid ang warrant, kinikilala nila ang warrant.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. warns corrupt and erring police personnel they will be held accountable by his administration. He spoke during the 123rd anniversary of the Philippine National Police. The president said he expects police under his administration to be disciplined, transparent, and fair. He also called on National Police Chief General Romel Marbil to uphold the rule of law.
Under General Marbil, the police have taken aggressive steps towards sustaining the gains of peace and order that we have collectively and painstakingly worked hard for. Erring and corrupt police personnel will face the appropriate sanctions. Remember, your mandate and place in public safety and service is at the core of your duty.
The Armed Forces of the Philippines says there's been no Chinese activity near Bajo de Masinloc despite Beijing's combat patrols in the South China Sea. The AFP says they have not seen any military drills near Scarborough Shoal. But it did monitor at least 3 Chinese vessels tailing ships that took part in the maritime exercises between the U.S., the Philippines, Australia, and Canada. The AFP assures the public it is in coordination with the Philippine Coast Guard and other relevant agencies to protect the West Philippine Sea. Now let's get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Chanel Dominguez. Good morning, Chanel.
Good morning, Bettina, and good morning to all. So currently, we are not monitoring any low-pressure area or tropical cyclone within and outside our Philippine area of responsibility that may affect us within the next 3 days. However, southwest monsoon or hanging habagat is still affecting Luzon and the western section of Visayas. Due to this, expect a cloudy skies with scattered rains and thunderstorms over Ilocos region, Zambales, and Bataan. For Metro Manila and the rest of our country, expect a partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain showers and high chances of rains during the afternoon and the evening due to localized thunderstorm. We currently have a thunderstorm advisory which is affecting Zambales, Bataan, Cavite, Metro Manila, Rizal, and Laguna within the next 2 hours. That's the latest here in Pag-asa Weather Forecasting Center. Chanel Dominguez, and good morning.
Thank you very much for that update, Chanel. Have a great weekend.